On to another development that shows the massive stress on the telecom sector, and especially for Vodafone Idea. The worsening financial position of the telecom company has led to Kumar Mangalam Birla, the chairman and the promoter of Vodafone, to write to the government saying that he is willing to give up his stake in an effort to save the company from what he has termed as an irretrievable collapse. The letter goes on to say that efforts to raise 25,000 crore rupees have not been successful due to the investors looking for clear government intent to have a three-player telecom market. Now, my colleague Avni Raja joining me on this particular issue. Let's in fact get an idea from Avni on what exactly the letter says. And when we say, Avni, that here you have, because of the worsening financial position, someone like Kumar Mangalam Birla now saying that he's willing to give up his stake, how should we read this? Because at the face of it, this sounds like a very big decision.
That's right, Afrida. Essentially, he has categorically clearly said that the company is in deep financial trouble, and unless the government steps in and supports it in some manner, it is going to become on the point of collapse as far as Vodafone Idea is concerned. And he's also said that given the fact that there are 27 crore people who are connected by Vodafone Idea, he says it is with a sense of duty towards those people that he is willing to hand over his stake in the company. And he says that any entity, public or private entity, that the government deems fit is fine with him as long as it saves the company. He has also said that all plans to raise funds earlier on to try and keep the operations going, that has not worked so far because investors, especially foreign investors, are looking to see some sort of support from the government to ensure that the company is going to survive. Because remember, the company right now is saddled with a debt of about 1.8 lakh crore. It owes a lot of money to the government as well in terms of pending dues at this point in time. So that is another aspect as well. So this clearly shows how, in what kind of financial trouble Vodafone Idea is. Now, of course, it remains to be seen how the government responds to this letter and whether or not some sort of solution is found, Afrida.
Okay, thanks for joining us, Avni, with the latest inputs on the story.